Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PyCharm, that is PyCharm version 2024.3 on a Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World Python program and how to start working on your Python assignments that you probably got from your school or college. So you know, do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be really going to benefit a lot from this video. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always ask me on our comment sessions and I'm always there to help you. And I'm also on Instagram now, so if you are facing any issues, you can also ask me over there as well. I'll definitely going to help you. So now to install PyCharm, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and then you need to search over here PyCharm download and hit enter. So that's going to show you this www.jetbrains.com as a first search result. So you need to click on this download PyCharm and immediately it's going to redirect to the official site of JetBrains. So this link, you know, I'm going to provide right in our description. So once when you are here using this link, you will be seeing that our PyCharm is available, that is latest version at the time of making of this video, which is 2024.3. Alright, so this is PyCharm professional one. So if you download this, you'll be able to use only 30 day free trial, and after that you need to pay some money to purchase this, or else what you can do is you just scroll down and you can download their community edition. So this community edition is, you know, free and built on open source, so you can, you know, download this one. Just click on the download button and immediately we'll see thank you for downloading PyCharm, and our file is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that our PyCharm community is rightly downloaded over here, and the file size is 517 MB. All right so once when it file gets downloaded, just simply double click on the exe to install it locally on our system. So it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and there you go. Welcome to PyCharm Community Edition setup. So this is our PyCharm installation wizard. Let's first minimize our download directory, and here just simply click on next. So this is the destination folder where our PyCharm is going to be installed. So on our C program files, it's going to create a JetBrains folder, and within that JetBrains folder, it's going to create another folder called PyCharm Community Edition, then the version name, which is 2024.3. All right. So only thing that you need to check is this available space. So currently I am having available space of 137 GB, which is totally fine. So this much space is what you required, 1.9 GB. So just verify this and just simply click on next after that. So that's going to show you this PyCharm Community Edition setup installation options. So all these different checkboxes you will see, you need to select everything. I'm going to explain what you are selecting. So first is desktop shortcut, so that's why you're selecting. So similar to Intel IJ IDEA, it's going to create another shortcut called PyCharm. All right, Intel IJ IDEA, how to install and all that, I have made a video about that just previous to this video, so you can always watch that. And the next option is open folder as project. So what happens is whenever you have a folder and when you right click, it's going to additionally show another option called open folder as project. So on clicking that, so what it's going to do is it's going to open that folder itself within PyCharm. So that's why it's, you know, I recommend you to select this one. And we are going to work on Python language. So that's why .py is what we want to associate it with our PyCharm. And finally, the fourth checkbox is this add bin folder to path. That's a very important option to select. So always check that. You need to restart your system. I'm going to talk about that in the coming part of the video. So for the time being, just simply select that and click on next. So here it's going to create a JetBrains folder, which is totally fine. Just simply click on install, and there you go. You can see immediately it rightly started installing our PyCharm. So our PyCharm Community Edition desktop shortcut is also created over here. So now it's going to take a couple of minutes. So by the time it gets installed, I'll request you, please do consider subscribing our Geeky Syntax channel. Here also regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos. So please do consider subscribing our Geeky Syntax channel along with Geeky Script blogging channel. That's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. So here let's wait for a couple of minutes. So So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that completing PyCharm community edition setup. So everything is fine. You need to reboot your system now. Select this reboot now and reboot your system. So after successfully restarting our system, let's come back to this video again. So welcome back. So after successfully rebooting your system, we'll begin landed over to the desktop, and you'll see PyCharm community edition desktop shortcut also over here. Just simply double click on it to start launching our PyCharm community edition. And there you go, you can see that it is rightly started launching. So you can see that our PyCharm is rightly launched, and it is telling whether you'd like to import all the settings from IntelliJ IDEA. So if you have previously installed IntelliJ IDEA, then you can always import all the settings directly from that software, or else if you are installing it just fresh, just click on skip import and welcome to PyCharm. So you can always maximize this. And here, let's create a new project. Just simply click on new project, and that's going to show you this new project window. So here you can see here we need to provide our project name. So let's give the project name as Hello World. And we'd also like to create a welcome script. And next, if you see these Python versions, so when you click on that, currently it is not showing anything because we don't have Python installed, right? So that's why it is very important to have Python installed on your system. Since I don't have Python installed, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on cancel. I'll close this, and I'll go to the official site of Python. So on our browser, I'll open a new tab, and I'll just type Python over here, Python download, and you'll get this python.org. So go to their official site and click on the latest version of Python that is available at the time. So our file is rightly downloaded. Let's install the Python. So accept this both these check boxes and click on custom installation. Everything keep it default. Next, and here check this install Python 3.13 for all users and click on install. So it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and immediately we'll see that our Python is rightly started installing. So let's minimize our browser and wait for a couple of minutes over here. So we can see that our Python is rightly installed. So setup was successful. You can close this. And now if you again reinvoke your PyCharm, so just simply double click on that shortcut. So welcome to PyCharm. And now again, if you click on this new project, this time on interpreter, we'll see that it is now recognizing the latest version of Python over here. So Python 3.13 slash python.exe is detected in the system, right? That is what it is showing. So I guess it is a bug. You need to manually install Python in order to get it visible over here. As you can see, if you want to downgrade Python and to some lesser version like Python 3.8 or 3.9, so your project might require a lower version of Python. So you can do that downgradation of your Python from here, but you can download Python right while installing PyCharm. So I guess it's a bug. It's not there on the previous versions, but now I can see that it is happening. So anyway, hope they will fix that in the upcoming versions. So you need to manually install Python, and then we are good to go. You need to provide your project name. So let's remove the existing and replace with Hello World. Check this checkbox of create a welcome script and just simply click on create. So immediately it's going to start creating our project. So creating virtual environment, and our Hello World project is rightly created. So let's first maximize it. So it is currently indexing. Let's wait for a minute. And there you go. So you can see that our main.py file is rightly open, and it resides in our project called Hello World, right? So here we have a method called printHi. So there we are having one argument called name, and that is what we are printing over here. Hi, and then the name. And here is our main method. So here we are calling this printHi by passing this parameter called PyCharm, and that gets printed as Hi PyCharm, right? So when you click on this run button, we're going to start building our project, and when it get builded, you're going to see the output. Hi PyCharm, rightly shown, right? So if you change this PyCharm with, let's say, Geeky Script, and just simply click on the run button again, you will see that it's going to show Hi Geeky Script. All right, so you can, you know, remove all this stuff and you can start working on your all Python assignments on PyCharm. All right, so don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos, and also you can, if you want, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. So that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.